questionable, you are the Lord. Unquestionable, you are the Lord. I'm
Multiple turnarounds await me this year.
Good news, our 2022-21 days fasting and prayer continues tomorrow to Sunday, January 30th, 2022. We shall meet daily from Monday to Thursday at 6:30 p.m. and on Friday from 11 p.m. to 2 a.m. for encounter nights in the church premises. On Friday, please break your fast with the communion at 6:30 p.m. Have some rest before coming for encounter night at 11 p.m. On Saturday, the DPC would meet as follows to break their fast with the communion. Monday DPC 4:30 p.m. to 5 p.m. Tuesday DPC 5:05 p.m. to 5:35 p.m. Thursday DPC 5:40 p.m. to 6:10 p.m. and Friday DPC 6:15 p.m. to 6:45 p.m. Be prepared to excel in all areas of life in 2022 as doors of blessing that come by favor are opened to you every day in Jesus' name. All through the period of our 21 days prayer and fasting, our DPC would not hold at the regular time, but would hold only on Saturdays as announced. Next Sunday at Joy Overflow is our end of the month Thanksgiving and Celebration Sunday worship service. It's a day of testimonies, a day to thank God for all His blessings to the Joy Overflow family and to mark the end of our 21 days fasting and prayer. Come with your best attires and dancing shoe to give God thanks and glory for the amazing testimonies that will become your portion in 2022 and beyond. The service runs from 9:30 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. Good news, we shall be partnering with Hope Mission to provide school lunches for some weeks. From the information provided to us, it costs about $1,670 to provide school lunches for 1 week. We request you to please donate the estimated dollar value of your missed food during these 21 days fasting and prayer to feed hungry kids. Isaiah chapter 58 verses 7 to 8 says, "Is it not to deal thy bread to the hungry, and that thou bring the poor that are cast out to thy house? When thou seest the naked, that thou cover him, and that thou hide not thyself from thine own flesh. Then shall thy light break forth as the morning, and thine health shall spring forth speedily, and thy righteousness shall go before thee. The glory of the Lord shall be thy reward." Please record the donation in the seed section of our offering envelope and mark it, Hope Mission. God bless you as you do. All workers and volunteers would have a training and information session at the church premises on Friday, January 28th from 9:30 p.m. Please make solid plans to attend. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Amen. Multiple turnarounds await me this year. Whoops. Oh, God is faithful to perform His word in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I'd like to welcome those of us online and on land to our day 15 of our 21 days prayer and fasting. Amen. Hallelujah. Shall we all rise up to pray in the presence of the Lord? Amen. And prayer number one is anchored on Psalms 124. Oh, okay. Sorry. If it had not been, shall we all read together, please? If it had not been the Lord who was on my side, now may Israel say, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, when men rose up against us, then they had swallowed us up quick, when their wrath was kindled against us. Then the waters had overwhelmed us, the stream had gone over our soul. Then the proud waters had gone over our soul. Blessed be the Lord who had not given us as a prey to their teeth. Our soul is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowler. The snare is broken and we are escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. Amen. And the prayer point goes, shall we all read? Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Thank you for protecting, defending, sustaining, and increasing us in all ramifications since the beginning of this year as a church and as individuals in Jesus' name. Let us raise our voices and begin to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, thank you for protecting. Thank you for defending. Thank you for sustaining. Thank you for increasing us in our ramification since the beginning of this year as a church and as individuals in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, let your name be praised. Let your name be exalted, O God. All glory and honor belong unto you, O God. We have come back to thank you. We have come back to say, Lord, you are worthy of all our praise in the name of Jesus. Blessed be your name tonight, Lord. Blessed be your name for all that you have done, O God, for divine protection, for defending us, for sustaining us, O God, for increasing us, O God, in every way, in every shape, in every form, O God. Thank you, O God, for you have done us well. In the mighty name of Jesus, makakaka makahebos, yekekeke makahaba, likahebos, makekeke makahaba, lakahebos. Father, we give you all the praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks. Amen. Praise the Lord. Prayer number 2 is anchored on Psalm 68 and verse 8. Shall we all read, please? God setteth the solitary in families. He bringeth all those which are bound with chains, but the rebellious dwell in dry land. Amen. And the prayer point goes thus. It says, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, settle every joyful celebrant desiring to be married this year in their matrimonial homes before this year ends. In Jesus' mighty name, let us begin to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, settle every joyful celebrant desiring to be married this year in their matrimonial homes before this year ends, oh God. Father, tonight, oh God, we are calling unto you, oh God, that your will be done, oh God, that your will be done, that your glory will be seen in the mighty name of Jesus before this year end, oh God. Lord, we shall testify of your goodness, of your mercy, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord God, settle every joyful celebrant desiring to be married this year, oh God. Let the door be open. Let the door be open in the mighty name of Jesus. Makakakahaba, yikasekaebos, rakokoko makahaba, likandahaba, lekekeke makahaba, likebos. Settle every joyful celebrant, Lord, in their matrimonial homes before this year end, oh God. In the name of Jesus, let your will be done, oh God. Makasikaba, likaebos, mandahaba. Father, we give you all the praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Prayer number 3 is anchored on Psalms 127 and verse 3. Shall we read, please? Lo, children are an heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. And the midwife, Exodus 1 and 19. And the midwife said unto Pharaoh, because the Hebrew women were not as the Egyptian women, for they are lively and are delivered, the midwives come in unto them. Amen. And the prayer point goes thus, shall we read, please? Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, let every joyful celebrant looking unto you for the fruit of the womb be rewarded accordingly, and let everyone that is pregnant deliver safely and after the order of the Hebrew woman. In Jesus' mighty name, let us raise our voice and begin to cry out to the Lord that his will be done this year, in the name of Jesus, that the Lord God will open every womb, that the Lord God will let his will be done in the mighty name of Jesus for all our expectant mothers and those who are desiring the fruit of the womb. Father, oh God, we call it forth, oh God, in the name of Jesus, we call it forth, oh God, by the power of the Holy Ghost, we mandate it, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, let every joyful celebrant looking unto you for the fruit of the womb, oh God, be rewarded accordingly in the name of Jesus, and let everyone that is present
makasikaba lekekekeaba likahebos lekekeke makaba lakahebos likekekeaba mandalebos rakasikaba lakokoko makaba. In the name of Jesus, let everyone bring forth their young safely like the Hebrew woman. In the name of Jesus, makokoko makaba likasikaebos mandalaba lakekeke makaba likandahaba. Do it, Lord. Do it, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Father, we give you all the praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. Prayer number 4 is anchored on Malachi 2 and verse 16. Shall we read, please? For I hate divorce, says the Lord, the God of Israel. To divorce your wife is to overwhelm her with cruelty, says the Lord of heaven's armies. So guard your heart. Do not be unfaithful to your wife. Amen. And the prayer point goes, thus shall we all read. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we decree an end to every form of marital crisis in all the marriages represented in Joy Overflow International Church, thereby destroying every taste for divorce from the roots. In Jesus' mighty name, raise your voices and begin to pray like never before. In the name of Jesus, Father, oh God, we decree an end to every form of marital crisis, every affliction in marriages, oh God. Lord, we decree an end now. We decree an end now. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we destroy every taste of divorce from the roots. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we destroy every taste for divorce from the roots. In the name of Jesus, we push back against every gate of hell, every plan of the enemy in our marriages, in our homes. In the name of Jesus, we destroy, oh God, every foundation of marital curse. In the name of Jesus, we destroy, oh God, every taste of divorce. In the name of Jesus, makakaka makaba lika seka hebos makekeke makaba lakanda hebos lakekeke haba lika seka haba laka hebos makokoko makaba. We destroy it, oh God, from the roots. In the name of Jesus, makokoko makaba, we push back against every gate of hell concerning, oh God, our marriages. In the name of Jesus, lakasikaba. Father, we give you all the praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Prayer number, 5, is anchored on Ephesians 5 and 33. Shall we read, please? Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife, even as himself, and the wife see that she reverence her husband. Amen. Be careful, Philippians 4, 6 to 7. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and your minds through Christ Jesus. Amen. And the prayer point says, shall we read, please? Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, let unity and love dwell in and around every marriage and family at Joy Overflow International Church all through this year and beyond, thereby giving us your supernatural peace that surpasses all understanding. In Jesus' mighty name, let us raise our voices and begin to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, let unity, let love dwell in and surround every marriage and family at Joy Overflow International Church all through this year and beyond, thereby giving us supernatural peace that surpasses all understanding. In the name of Jesus, Father, oh God, we shall dwell in peace, love, unity, oh God, in our marriages and our family, oh God, all through this year and beyond. In the Jesus. Makarebos. Yekekeke makaba. Likarebos. Makakaka makaba. Lakarebos. Inkarebos. Makekeke makaba. Likarebos. Father, we give you all the praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Prayer number 6 is anchored on Psalms 24 and verse 1. It says, shall we read, please? The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. Amen. Proverbs 21 and 1. It says, the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. As the rivers of waters, he turneth it wheresoever he will. Psalms 2 and verse 8. It says, ask me to give you the nations, I will do it, and they shall come before your legacy. Your domain will stretch to the ends of the earth. Amen. And the prayer point goes, thus shall we read, please. Father, in the name of Jesus, grant every joyful celebrant believing you for their work permit and permanent residence in their petitions in this first quarter of the year 2022. In Jesus' name, let them find and obtain favor with the government of Canada. In Jesus' mighty name, let's begin to intercede for all those who are believing God for divine favor. In the mighty name of Jesus, Yakasikaba, Yakoko Makaba, Makaibos, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, grant divine favor for all those who are believing you, trusting you, oh God, for work permits, permanent residence, oh God, Lord, grant them favor, oh God, in the name of Jesus, favor, oh God, like never before, in the name of Jesus, let the door be open, let every door be open, in the mighty name of Jesus, let your will be done, let your glory be seen, oh God, in their petitions, oh God, in the name of Jesus, Father, Lord God, grant every heart request, every heart desire, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lakahebos, lekekeke makahaba, likahaba, lekekeke makahaba, andalebos, makahaba, let your will be done, oh God, divine favor, oh God, on the left, on the right, in the name of Jesus, lekaba, mandalebos, let there be turnarounds, oh God, this year, in the first quarter, in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you all the praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. It's time for personal supplication. And I shall read Romans 8:28. It's a verse that we all know. It says, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love God and to them who are called according to his purpose. What it is saying is that it doesn't matter what this year may bring, nothing shall work against you. Everything shall work for your good. Everything that God says, it shall come to pass. It shall work for your good in the name of Jesus. You can take your proper positions. You can kneel at the altar. You can lay in whichever way you like. Let us begin to intercede concerning your petitions in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Let us begin to magnify the name of the Lord. Let us begin to thank Him. Thank Him for His faithfulness. Father, we thank you, Lord. We magnify your name tonight, Lord. We give you the praise, oh God. May you take all the glory. May you take all the honor, oh God. We exalt your name, oh God, because you have answered every prayer tonight, oh God. Father, we bless your name. We give you all the praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. Shall we have a seat in the presence of the Lord as we welcome our senior pastor?
Hallelujah. I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been kept in your hand. From the moment that I wake up till I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. Has God been faithful to you? All my life you have been so. That's it.
Your goodness is not enough. It's not enough for me. When my life lay down, I surrendered all. I give you everything. Your goodness is not enough. It's not enough for me. Your goodness is not enough. It's not enough for me.
Hallelujah. All through the year 2022, you shall experience the goodness of the Lord. The Lord shall be good to you all through this year. In the morning, it will be good. In the afternoon, it will be good. In the evening, he will be good. He is a covenant-keeping God. And his covenants have never failed. It will not fail in your life. In the name of Jesus. Let's ask the Lord right now, speak to my heart. Let your word come for me. Open my eyes to see. Let my ears hear a word. In the name of Jesus, that will keep me on fire for you all through the year 2022. In the name of Jesus, let your word come for me that will keep me on fire all through this year. Let your word come for me. Open my eyes to see that word. Open my spirit, man, Lord, to receive that word. In the name of Jesus, and build me up Nebahora ate. In this fasting and prayer period, build me up. Neato. Let my hand lay hold of eternal life. Let my hand lay hold of eternal life. Let my hand lay hold of eternal life. In the name of Jesus. And I thank and praise you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, let there be utterance given to me tonight to express divine mandates to your people tonight. And let the word come with healing. Let the word come with deliverance. Let yokes be broken. Let burdens be destroyed. Let your people be lifted. Let miracles and signs be the norm. We thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name we are praying. Put those hands together and make a loud noise. Give him glory. Woo! I love the Lord so much. He's so faithful. He cares about every details of our lives. There is nothing that is too small to bring to God, and nothing is too big to talk to him about. He cares for every little detail. So in this fasting and prayer, please make sure everything, you talk to God about everything. Everything. Every detail of your life, talk to him about it. He's your Father. He cares. And you'll be surprised what he will do for you. This year, God will surprise you. This year, God will overwhelm you with blessing. This year, the hand of the Lord shall establish you, strengthen and settle you in Jesus' precious name. Amen. I want to thank God for your life and how you've given yourself to this fasting. You are the one that will enjoy the benefit. Men will look at you this year and say, whoa, where did you go? He said, I went to the house of the Lord. We waited on the Lord for 21 days, and God heard my prayer. That shall be your portion, and that shall be your testimony. That shall be your song in the name of Jesus Christ. There are benefits in praying and fasting. I'm going to be bringing out another one tonight, which is the voice of God. Woo! Say the voice of God. The voice of God. The voice of God. Now, what is the voice of God? It is the voice of the Holy Ghost that brings a confirmation of God's word. It brings instructions, corrections, and judgment against the enemy. And it does a lot more. The voice of God does a lot more. In Psalm 29, verse 3 to 9, the Bible speaking says, the voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thundereth. The Lord is upon many waters. The voice of the Lord is what? Powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord breaketh the cedars. Yea, the Lord breaketh the cedars of Lebanon. Let me let you know that cedars are one of the strongest trees or wood in the world. Very strong. But without an axe, the word of the Lord can penetrate, the voice of the Lord can penetrate it and break it to pieces. That's what that place is saying. So, no matter how hard the thing is, all you need is the voice of the Lord. It comes for judgment. It comes for mercy. It comes for instructions. It guides, it leads. He wants to show you. He's more willing to show you than you are more willing to receive. There is a frequency that emits the voice of the Lord. A frequency permanently where the voice of the Lord keeps speaking. So you and I can access this as one of our benefits in fasting and prayer. Once you get to that level, you begin to hear the voice of the Lord and you obey that voice and you yield yourself to the dictates of the word, your life never remains the same. Because you want to take a wrong step, it tells you, no, stop. Don't do it. Don't go there. Many times the Lord has corrected me. I will think in my own heart, this is the best way to do it. He said, no, that's not how to do it. Don't go that way. The voice instructs. Very strong voice. It was the same voice I heard in May 2015 that made me go after him and say, take the job. He said, give me your job. Son, give me this job. I said, Father, you just spoke. He said, yes. I waited on the Lord 3 days, confirmed it. I said, thank you, Father. And before that same voice has spoken to my wife. He said, I also call your husband to full-time ministry. So when I was, you know, such things are very heavy to sell a madam. I said, madam, the Lord said, I should give you my job. For a carnal woman, what's the first question she will ask? What are we going to be eating? You're giving up your job. Eh? So you are not this, you want to follow this God. But before I got there, the Lord already got there before me. So when I was telling her and I was saying, maybe there is something that I want us to discuss, and I've been praying. I've asked the Lord, you know, for confirmation, and I had to set aside 3 days. I began to explain. She said, what is it? The Lord is calling you to full time. I said, whoa, what's going on here? She said, the Lord spoke to me already. So the voice of the Lord, this year 2022, may you not be deprived of the voice of the Lord. Look at it, let's go on. It said the voice, verse 6, he maketh them also to skip like a calf, Lebanon and Syrian like a young unicorn. The voice of the Lord divided the flames of fire. So no matter the fire that the enemy will put up against you, all you need is the voice of the Lord against it. Stop! What do you think quenched the fire of Nebuchadnezzar? It was blazing hot, but the voice of the Lord was around there, so the fire could not burn. This year, Kaloho Siraha, every fire set up by the enemy, the voice of the Lord quenches them. In the name of Jesus Christ. He said, the voice of the Lord shaketh the wilderness. The Lord shaketh the wilderness of Kadesh. So the voice goes to shake the wilderness. It begins to shake it. He said, the voice of the Lord makes the hinds to calve. The hind is a female deer. When God speaks, he said the female deer will just give birth immediately. Hey, what can't you do, Jesus, maker of the universe? What can't you do? What can't you do, Jesus? You are able. Great and mighty God, you are able, Jesus. Let me tell you what that thing is saying. A nation can be born in one day by the voice of God. Israel, for 430 years, we are kept in bondage, but by the voice of the Lord, it became a nation overnight. Amen. Let me let you know, see, you and I need to use this period of fasting to access God, access heaven. There is nothing he cannot do. You are looking for a husband, you are looking for a child. God can make all of it happen for you in 1 year. By his voice. By his voice. You are looking for a car. You are looking for a house. You are looking for a business. It can happen for you in 1 year. 1 year too much. Just his voice is what you need. Once you secure his voice, he goes ahead and does it. He maketh the hinds to calve. In other words, a female deer, if a female deer can just give birth instantly, who told you that you can't give birth instantly right now? And discovered the forest, and in his temple doth everyone speak of his glory. God wants to take the glory over your life this year. Just give him access. Tell your neighbor, give him access. Give God access. Give God access. Make yourself available. Tell him, Lord, have your way. Have your way in my life. Do what pleases you in my life. There is nothing God does in your life that makes your life go back. If it is God behind it, it must go forward. Shall a nation be born in one day? Yet before Zion travailed, she brought forth a man child. That's the voice of the Lord. Before Zion travailed, she brought forth a man child. So all of it can come together for you this year. All you need is what? Secure the access to the voice of the Lord. Why do we need the voice of the Lord? It was the same voice that spoke to Saul on the way to Damascus. While he was going to Damascus to kill the people, this Saul was hardened. He was a hard guy. As a matter of fact, when they were killing Stephen, they gathered their clothes and put it at his feet. But the voice of the Lord turned him instantly from a murderer to a preacher. Instantly. He doesn't need go and come. If God speaks, that's it. How did God create the heaven and earth? Have you forgotten? Let there be light. And the forces of darkness said, no, we must give way. Light has come. Let the waters be separated from the land. Since then, it hasn't changed now. The waters are separate. The land is separate. How? The voice of the Lord. Let there be herb yielding trees yielding fruits across. Instantly, what happened? Trees grew, or shrubs grew, vegetables grew, flowers grew, trees grew, all manner. Just one voice is separated to the several. How many species of trees and plants do you know? Has science succeeded in counting it? How were they created? By the voice of the Lord. So do you think your own issue will take forever voice of God? No. This year, I see you securing access to the voice of the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ. It was the voice that Paul heard. And you know the thing about the voice of God, when you hear that voice, it's very difficult to doubt it. He speaks so majestically that it overwhelms the whole situation. Paul was overwhelmed by that voice. Who are you, Lord? He didn't know the Lord before. But instantly, the voice taught him the Lord. Who are you, Lord? What must I do, Lord? A murderer asking God, the one who he was persecuting. He was asking him, what must I do, Lord? The voice of God. So it can turn a hardened criminal to a preacher of the gospel. It can take a man that was a nobody and put him on the throne just like Joseph overnight. Overnight. In one day. In one day, a prince was born. In one day, a king was born. In one day, a prime minister was born by the voice of the Lord. All Joseph needed was the voice of God. The voice of God created a problem that nobody else had a solution for. This year, 2022, the voice of the Lord will create solutions for you. And as Saul was still asking the Lord, what must I do? That same voice at the same time went to a man called Ananias. Say, Ananias, Saul is now my own. Go and lay your hands on him. And then the scale in his eyes will fall off. He is on this street and on that specific, very detailed and graphic. God never speaks to confusion of anybody. No. If you are confused, that's not the voice of God. Ah, God, I don't know whether what God wants me to do, whether I should, start buying and selling car. I'm just confused. God's voice never confuses anybody. Tell your neighbor, God's voice never confuses anybody. When he speaks clearly. Ananias, go to the street called Straight. There is in the house of one Simon the Tanner, a man called Saul of Tarsus. Now he is my own. My hand is upon him. Go and lay your hands upon him. Specific and direct. God knows street numbers. He knows the address of your house. He knows the address of your house. And this year, your house will be visited by the Lord. The voice of the Lord instructed a man called Cornelius in Acts chapter 10. That voice went to Cornelius. He said he was a devout man. He loved God so much. He was doing everything. But he wasn't doing it right because he believed only in the baptism of John. So the voice went to him, Cornelius, send for a man called Peter. He is in this house. Send people to go and call him. And as the time they were reaching his house, the same voice went to Peter and said, Peter, three men seek thee. Follow them and do what I have asked them to do. The voice of the instructive, very clear instruction. This year you will hear clear instructions. In the name of Jesus. The voice of the Lord was audible on the Mount of Transfiguration. On the Mount of Transfiguration, when Jesus took Peter, James, and John, they went to the mountain. And the voice came, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear ye him. And remember when Peter was writing, he said, the things which we have heard, the things we have seen, the things which we have handled of the word of life, the voice came so mighty, they were not confused. They know who was speaking. When you hear God's voice, you know who is speaking, son. Because it comes with an aura around you. You cannot explain it, but you just know this is God. Wow, this is God. I just heard God right now. I just heard. Someone will say, something told me. That's not something. It's God. So let's press in the Spirit to hear the voice of the Lord. In the Old Testament, he spoke severally to our fathers, to the prophet, where you thus hear the Lord and, arise, go to this place, do that. So this year, I see you a beneficiary of the voice of the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, I saw something in Scriptures. So the voice of the Lord can come anytime, but more specifically when we are fasting, one of the benefits we have is that we can have access to the voice of the Lord. For instance, today, an issue came up. And I said, God, I need to hear your voice over these issues. One after the other, without missing word. You do this, write this down, call this person, tell that person this, as I was asking. So you have access, say I have access to the voice of God. Ask him and you shall what? Receive. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door shall be opened unto you. Say to the Lord, Lord, this fasting and prayer must not end. I want to hear your voice. And you will hear him. So when you make that request, you stay quiet in his presence, in the spirit. As you are in the spirit and praying, you'll be hearing the instructions. one after the other. One after the other, he will be issuing the instruction. It happened to the man called Barnabas. In Acts chapter 13, verse 2, the Bible says, as they ministered to the Lord and did what? Fasted, the Holy Ghost said. As they ministered to the Lord and did what? Fasted, the Holy Ghost said. Separate me, Barnabas and Saul, for the work whereunto I have called them. So this year you will hear the voice of God. As you fast, as you pray, create a little time and say, Lord, let me hear your voice. Practice it. Start. Practice it and say, Lord, stay there until you hear something. And see, the way the voice of the Lord works is when he speaks to you, he'll be speaking his word. His word and his will be confirming it right there. It also happened to the man Cornelius. I talked about it. Acts chapter 10 verse 30. And Cornelius said, 4 days ago, I was what? What was I doing? I was fasting until this hour. And the ninth hour, I prayed in my house. And behold, a man stood before me in bright clothing. But what was he doing? He was fasting. So fasting gives you access to the voice of the Lord. Please explore it. Tell your neighbor, please explore it. Please explore it. What is wrong with most of us is that we are not patient enough. Oh Lord, speak to me now. Speak to me now. Speak to me now. Speak to me now in Jesus' name. 1, 2, 3, 4. You're not speaking, Lord. 5. You're not even at peace. You are not even at peace. Speak to me, Lord. Stay. If it is 1 hour he speaks, stay there. In the spirit. Pray in the spirit. If it is 30 minutes, stay there. If it is 2 hours, stay there. You are the one who are asking for the voice of the Lord. And he will come when he will come. You can't force him. He will come. Daniel chapter 9 verse 3. I set my face unto the Lord to seek by prayer and supplication with fasting and sackcloth and ashes. In verse 21 to 22, yea, while I was speaking in prayer, even the man Gabriel, whom I had seen in the vision at the beginning, being caused to fly swiftly, touched me about the time of the evening oblation, and he informed me. So the voice of God came for him. Fasting and waiting. 21 days. Lord, I need to hear your voice. I need to hear what you are saying. That voice came and he informed me and talked with me and said, Daniel, oh Daniel, I am come now. I am now come forth to give this skill and understanding. That is what God will do for someone in Jesus' name. So when you spend time fasting and prayer, you have equal access to the voice of the Lord. Ask him and he will speak. He will speak. But we need to learn the art of being patient in his presence, and then we will see his power go forth. Praise God. Now, Prophetess Anna in Luke chapter 2, verse 36 to 38. Let's read together. And there was one Anna, a prophetess, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was of a great age and had lived with her husband 7 years from her virginity. Verse 37. And she was a widow of about 84 years, which departed not from the temple, but served God with what? Fastings. So your fasting is a service to God. Serve God with fastings and prayer, night and day. So when you are fasting, know you are in a service to God. And she, coming in that instant, gave thanks likewise unto the Lord and spake of him to all that look for redemption in Jerusalem. So she had access to the voice of God that told her that, look, a Savior is going to be born. You are not going to die until you have seen that Savior. Why? She was fasting and praying night and day as a service to God. So she had access to the voice of God. So you too, you have access to the voice of God. The mandate of this commission in September 10, 2015 came from the voice, 2016, sorry, came from the voice of the Lord. September 10 to 12, 2016, I stood before God and I heard his voice about what his plan is and agenda is for us right now at Joy Overflow. So Joy Overflow International Church is not a corner-side church that just started, you know, because Pastor Sonny and Pastor Fuller, they just wanted to create a church. No. It was not my idea. And I've told us before, by the grace of God, I qualified as a chartered accountant at the age of 24, many, many years ago. I'll be 55 in August. Woo! At the age of 24, so I practice accounting. I love it so much. And left to me, that's what I would do. That's what I was doing in Fort McMurray. When God said, boy, give me this job. And let me let you know, it wasn't that only time we heard him. We have been hearing him over. And today I heard him. Over still on Joy Overflow International Church. I heard God today. How many of us were here on the night of Oil of Joy? Let me let you know, that lady that came from upstairs, the Lord spoke to me about it. As I was praying and said, Lord, the night of the Oil of Joy, what's your plan? He said, there is a lady that will be sitting on the upper floor. There is something with the left ear. All you need to do is put your hand in the air, put oil in your finger, put it in the air, and speak to it to open. And brethren, that night, honestly, that was another dimension for me. As I was saying, there's somebody here, your left ear. And all of a sudden, from the top floor, I saw the person, the same side the Lord said the person is coming from. I said, oh, Father, this is another level. In this season of fasting, you will go to another level. I see you go to another level in the name of Jesus Christ. So you have access to the voice of the Lord. We're going to pray. If you don't mind, let's rise up. We're going to pray. Hallelujah. We're going to pray from this scripture, Exodus chapter 15, verse 26. Let's read together. He said, if you will listen carefully to the voice of the Lord your God and do what is right in his sight, obeying his commands and keeping all his decrees, then I will not make you suffer any of the diseases I sent on the Egyptian, for I am the Lord who heals you. Do you know the reason why some people suffer? They lack the voice of the Lord. This year, you will not suffer. So we're going to pray like this. Number one prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, let's read together. May I hear your voice on every issue of my life throughout this year and beyond in Jesus' name. Raise your voice and ask the Lord. Ask the Lord. Lord, I want to hear your voice over every issue of my life in this year and beyond. Nelibaroro sambrehetia teka askopira tagayata panimorodo shabigata laketo sikatara hateba. Father, in the name of Jesus, give me access to your voice on every issue of my life in the year 2022. I want to be able to hear you clearly. I want to hear you like a man hears his friend. I want to continue to hear you, Lord, all through the year 2022 on every issue of life that will come up. Nesiara toga, as I kneel before you in prayer, as I stand before you in prayer, Menia toga, grant me access to your voice. Grant me continuous access to your voice. Grant me continuous access. Zariadoto, shapreket, as I stand before you in praying, in fasting, in service unto you, Jesus, Kedira ta, Mianosh Kambihale, Esira Namanos Kambalata, Anayatoso Preketekati, Layato Zebrahandebana, Netua, your powerful voice, your fire dividing voice, your water dividing voice, your voice that is powerful. Nariado, Lady Zarondahata, Amo Shahate. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name, we are praying. Amen. Say a born again, amen. Now, the last prayer we're going to pray, the second prayer and last prayer. We're going to say, Father, by the blood of Jesus, as I obey your voice and command this year and beyond, keep all illnesses, diseases, misfortune, and all the evil plans of the wicked away from me and my household in Jesus' name. Let's pray that prayer. Father, by the blood of Jesus, as I obey your voice and commands this year and beyond, keep all illnesses, all diseases, all misfortunes, and all the wicked plans of the enemy away from me. Keep it away from your church. Keep it away from my household. In the name of Jesus, in the year 2022 and beyond, keep away evil. Keep away wickedness of the devil. Keep away all illnesses, sicknesses, diseases from my household. Keep it away. Keep it away. Block their access to my household. Block their access to me. Block their access. Zarabata Gatea. Akarakatia deba. Nezibo hoshakata. Emina zandora diate. Ekepita takarata. Lopira de gayata. Azemino hoto. Emprapatakata. Zandido tasa. Aretialo. Edizaradaba. Kati. Pray some more. Press in the Spirit, press in the Holy Ghost. Madiarada, Kobila Baradate, Ezimanahate, Kimanosh Kambadita, Azazazaza Tukete, Podira Gadaba, Kalida Dagato, Zobida Braante, Mashambi Hotele, Ateko Pata, all illnesses, all diseases, all sicknesses, all misfortune, all evil plan of the wicked, away from me, away from me, go away from me, in 2022 and beyond, go away from me, go away from me, the blood of Jesus against you, 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 go away from me, go away from my household, lose your grip over my life, lose your grip over the church of God, in the name of Jesus, no one shall be called sick in this church, this year, in the name of Jesus, Nate, as we keep being obedient to you, Jesus, Nelo Darada, we break Katada, we break Ketulaba, Ezida Data, Lampera Katia de Maseto. Woo! In Jesus' precious name, we are praying. The Holy Spirit wants us to pray one more prayer. Father, by the voice of the Lord, break every hard issues in the life of any joyful celebrant that may arise this year and beyond. In the name of Jesus, break. Let's raise my voice. Father, by your voice, break, 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 break every hard issue that may arise in the life of any joyful celebrant this year. We command it to break. We command it to break. We command it to break. By your voice, let it be broken. By your voice, let it be broken. By your voice, let it be broken. Any hard issue that may arise against any one member of this church or anyone online or anyone who is associated with us this year, 2022, against your church, any hard issue, we break it. We break it. We break it. We break it. Break, 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 break. In the name of Jesus, break. By the blood of Jesus, break. Tahate. Kalosha. Zeni mahatalaba. Treniado zalihate. Panimalo zandohata. Pandia shokata. He nimolo radahata. Mianosha. Thank you, Father. We give you praise. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' name we are praying. Let's thank the Lord for answered prayers. Father, we thank you for those answered prayers. We give you all the glory in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Hallelujah. Put those hands together. Make a loud noise. Give God glory. Shall we go to the communion table? And I will ask the studio to please help us with the communion scripture. 1 Corinthians chapter 10. Verse 16 and verse 21. It describes the communion as the cup of blessing. What is this? The cup of blessing, which we bless. Is it not the communion of the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not the communion of the body of Christ? Verse 21. I cannot personalize this. I cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of devils. I cannot be partaker of the Lord's table and of the table of devils. This is called the cup of blessing. He said, when you choose the cup of blessing, you cannot partake of curses. So all curses around your life are reversed forever. By the communion tonight, all curses around your life are reversed forever. Thank you, Father, in Jesus. And shall we distribute? Cut it open when you have it. Just open it up. Break it yet.
Nothing
but the Lord Jesus. Yes, say Katalaba, Nanebo Sharahata, Lame de Brete Katete, Asira Hatala, Naziateka, Alla Katerade, Azuza Haterada, Malibo Sharikata, Pranianema O Salita, Hezira Dapata, Kalebo Sha, Kanema Santolabara, Ebi Halzara Teka Lapata, Kolebruho Shakate, Mezi Hatekate. Akata la barada, Jose dia tegala, ena ho shante, nana boho serata, kalabayata, rabadhate, enia lo salabarata.
Shall we take the flesh, lift it up, and raise it above you? This is the blessed body of the Lord. As we partake of it tonight, I decree a divine reversal of every negativity in anyone's body. Whatever cannot be found in the body of Jesus that is found in your body gives way instantly. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, shall we eat together? Let's lift up the blood. This is the blood that Jesus shed on the cross and said is the blood of my new covenant. Amen. I decree as we partake of this blood of the new covenant, amen, every new thing that God wants to do in 2022 shall be represented in us. Amen. This year, you will experience newness. Amen. New fire. Amen. Fresh fire on your altar. Amen. This year, there shall be divine revelation. Amen. Access to the voice of the Lord. Amen. So shall it be. Amen. In Jesus' precious name, shall we eat together. Take the remnant of it, smear it all over you. Everywhere there's pain, command it to go away in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. We give you praise. We give you glory. Let's lift up our hands. Let's appreciate God for that awesome time tonight. Let's celebrate the faithfulness of God. Celebrate the faithfulness of God. Father, we thank you for tonight for access to your word and your voice. We give you glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Have a seat in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. What a word from heaven. The voice of the Lord. The voice of the Lord. I just pray that our ears will be open to hear when he speaks in Jesus' name. Amen. Do we have anybody fellowshipping with us for the first time today? Hallelujah. This church, Joy Overflow International Church, is soon becoming a place of worship for how many? Hundreds of thousands. So what do? Watch out. Take your place and be ready for what is already happening. Finally, let's remain focused on peace, love, and joy, and maintain zero tolerance for strife. Strife will not be mentioned among us in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's welcome our Father in the Lord.
Hallelujah. Day 15. God. Woo! How many more days to go? 6 days. You are saying 7. Okay, you will continue for us. 6 more days to go. Glory to God. May you be strengthened the remaining 6 days. May the hand of the Lord rest upon you. Every answer that you are expecting will come rushing at you. These 6 days remaining shall be days of testimonies. They shall be days of encounters for you. In the name of Jesus. Don't give in on the prayer altar. Keep pressing. Keep pressing. You are very close. Keep pressing. Keep pressing. You are very close. In the name of Jesus. You shall finish strong. I said you shall finish strong. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. God is a good God. So remember, we meet again tomorrow. I want to appeal to those of us who are online. Please, come online. Let's talk. Let's appeal to them. Please, come online. God bless you as you do, in Jesus' name. It's going to be another encounter night tomorrow. Let's be here. Let's wait upon the Lord, standing strong on the prayer mountain. And I can tell you, God is doing amazing things in Jesus' name. You are blessed and highly lifted. As you go, the blessing of the Lord accompanies you. The hand of the Lord rests over you. His glory cover you. Tonight, as you press, you will hear his voice. Tomorrow, you will hear his voice. All the days in 2022, you will hear the voice of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Shall we share the covenant together? Let's go. God will show me the path of life, for in his presence is the fullness of my joy, and at his right hand are my pleasures forevermore. Peace, love, and joy. Turn to your neighbor and assure them, my glory is here. No loss, no pain, no shame. Turn to somebody else, assure them, my glory is here. No loss, no pain, no shame. No loss, no pain, no shame forever in Jesus' name. Shall we take our covenant song?
Joy overflows in my heart. Sing a new song.
Take a Mazamboro.